Hello dear participants, I welcome you all in this lecture number 6, Data Cleaning in MS Excel. This lecture will deal with few questions. Questions are as follows. What is data cleaning? Why should we go with data cleaning? How to do data cleaning? And the last question, what are the different data cleaning techniques in MS Excel? So this lecture will try to answer all these questions. Objective of this lecture is to make you familiar with data cleaning techniques in MS Excel. So let me start with the meaning of a concept, data cleaning. What is data cleaning? Data cleaning is simply a process to remove irregularities which we commit in the data. Usually when we collect our data, we arrange that data in MS Excel, and that data is known as a raw data. Why we call it raw data? And why we don't apply statistical things on this raw data? Because this raw data may contain some irregularities. What type of the irregularities that this raw data can contain? They are as follows. That raw data can have some typographical irregularities. That raw data can have some missing values, blank cells, or some error messages in a particular cell. That thing can be there in the raw data, and there is possibility that we are having some outliers. What are outliers? Outliers are some sort of extraordinary number, a very different number than the general pattern of the data. Fine. So all they are the irregularities in our raw data. So to identify these irregularities, we need data cleaning. We need data cleaning process. So on the raw data, if we go with the data cleaning process on this raw data, then we'll get a proper data on which we can apply some statistical techniques, and then we'll get proper results. Fine. If we apply statistics on raw data, it may lead you to the confusing results or the wrong results. Now there are different techniques of data cleaning. We'll discuss few techniques here in this lecture. Which techniques that we are going to discuss here in this lecture? We are going to discuss here how can we identify blank cells, how can we identify error cells, how can we identify duplicates, how can we remove those duplicates, how can we apply upper, lower and proper case on the quality to data, which is alphabetical data, fine. And how can we remove the extra space given in the alphabetical data or the qualitative data. So these techniques that we are going to discuss in this lecture. So let me start with the identification of the blank cell. And to understand this, let me take you all to the sample data. So here is a sample data set. This is a very small data set. Actually, in actual, we are having a large large data sets, and here in the small data set, simply looking at the data, we can identify the blank cells. Means they are like, here is one of the blank cell, here is one of the blank cell, here is one of the blank cell, and here it is. But when we are having large data set, it is quite difficult to identify blank cells simply looking at the data. So to make it more simple, we use that some process using which we can identify those blank cells for the large data. Here we are using the small data set only to understand the process, that how can we identify the blank cell. So let me take you all to the process. What is the first step? First step is that you will have to select your whole data set. I have selected here. Then I'll have to go to home, and if in home, I'll have to go to conditional formatting. Then I'll have to click here on conditional formatting. Then I'll have to click on new rule. And if I click on new rule, new pop-up window appears. There are different options, but I will have to choose this option. It is format only cells that contains. What it contains? That you are going to answer clicking this arrow. Once I click on this arrow, there are different options. If I click blank, I'll be going with the blank cells. At the same time, if I'll click errors, it will highlight error cells. Fine. But so far this slide is concerned, this part of this lecture is concerned, we are going to identify blank cells. So I'll click here on the blank. Then I'll click here on the format. Why format? Format will help us to give some particular color for the blank cells. Fine. So I'll click here on the red color and I'll click on OK. And again, here I'll click on OK. Now here are the blank cells and they are highlighted with the red color. This is the way that we identify blank cells. Fine, in MS Excel. Now I'll go further. How to identify error cell? As I explained it earlier too, in a very brief. Now error, see error term, why we get error in different cells? Errors are actually associated with the functions. If you are having some particular variable which is associated with the function, if you have given some formula and you have generated some variable, then if there is some technical problem, then error thing appears in that particular cell. What I mean to say, let's see. Suppose here in this sample data set, we are computing one more, we are generating one more variable, and that is per head income. How to compute per head income? Per head income is nothing but income divided by number of members in a family. Now I am having these two variables. I am having these two variables data here. Monthly income is here and members in family is also here. So what I'll do? I'll simply perform one formula here. And what is the formula? Is equal to E2 divided by F2. What does that mean? Is equal to monthly income divided by members in family. So that is the function, that is the formula that I'm applying here. And then I'll press enter. As I press enter, I got the per head income for the first respondent. Then should I type that formula every time here for all the respondents? There is really no need to do that. So simply I'll go to corner of this cell and I'll just drag it to the end. So I'll automatically get all the per head income for respective respondents. Now here in this, if you look carefully, here is the error term. Then how to identify such error term? Again, thing is, this is very a small set of data. Simply looking at the data, we can identify error cell here. But if we are having a very large data set, then it is really becomes very difficult that to identify error cells. So to identify error cells, MS Excel help. How it helps? Let's see the process. Again, I'll have to select whole data. Then after selecting this whole data, I'll have to click on home. Then I'll have to go to conditional formatting in new rule. Then format only cells that contains. I'll have to click on this arrow and I'll have to select errors, because so far this part of lecture is concerned, we are interested in errors now. Fine. Then after selecting errors, I'll have to click on format. As I click on the format, here I'll give different color. I'll choose here yellow color. So I'll click here on the yellow and then I'll click on OK, and that error cell is now highlighted with yellow color. Fine. So this is the way that we identify a blank cell and error cell. Fine. Now let me take you all to the MS Excel to demonstrate the same thing which we have learned. Fine. So here is the same sample data that we have discussed. Fine. So simply I'll have to select this data, then I'll have to go to home, then I'll have to go to conditional formatting, then I'll have to go to new rule. I'll click on the new rule. Now I'll click on format only cells that contain. Fine. And then I'll go to here, format only cells with blanks. First we'll identify blanks. Then I'll click on format, then I'll click on red thing, find OK, and then I'll click on OK. So all these red things are the blank cells. Now I'll generate one variable which will contain some formula. So is equal to monthly income divided by members in family. I'll press enter. I got the per head income for the first respondent. Then I'll go to this corner and I'll drag it to the end. Now I got all the per head income for all respondents. Now here is my error. How to identify this error? Again, I'll have to click, I'll have to select all this data. Then I'll have to go to conditional formatting. I'll have to go to new rule, and in new rule I will have to select format only cells that contains, and then I'll have to click on this arrow and I'll have to select errors. So I have selected error, then I'll go to format and I'll give different color because red is already used. I'll give yellow color and I'll press OK, and then again OK. So here is the yellow color. So error cell is highlighted with yellow and blank cells are highlighted with red. Now it depends on you that either you can remove this variable or you can put an average value here. It depends on you that what you want to do with this error cells and the blank cells. Fine. Now let me take you all back to my presentation. Now we are going to perform here, means we are going to understand here that how can we identify duplicates. So again, here is a sample data with us. Now here, to identify duplicate cells, simply I'll select all my data, then I'll go to home, and in home I'll go to conditional formatting, and in conditional formatting now I'll go to highlight cells rule. Now highlight cells rules, there are different options out of which we are interested in duplicate values. So I'll click on duplicate values. As I click on duplicate value, I'll get one new pop-up window. Fine. And duplicate is already mentioned here. And if I click here on this arrow, different options appear. They are nothing but they are just formatting things. What type of color that you want to use to show the duplicate, that thing is here. So simply I'll choose first one, light red fill with dark red text. So I'll click on this and then I'll click on OK. Here are the duplicate cells. How to interpret this? See, all the reddish part, they are showing the duplicate cells. Fine. For example, this BA is repeated here. This BA is duplicate of this. This BA is duplicate of this. This BA is duplicate of this. That way it perform. Fine. But we are more interested in a complete row. This row, Ankit Sharma, this complete row is reddish. What does that mean? It means that this complete row is duplicate somewhere. By mistake, we have typed the same respondent. We have considered the same respondent here. So Ankit Sharma came twice. The whole data came twice. Why to remove these duplicate cells? Why they are very harmful? Because it will lead you to the wrong results. It will lead you to the wrong conclusions once we apply the statistics. Correct. John Abraham, again the same story with John Abraham. He also came twice. Where he is here, he is here. Same story with the Nazima Sheikh, Kamal Kumar. Fine. So there are four cases which came twice. So that is the way that we identify duplicate cells. Now next part is how to remove duplicates. To remove duplicates, what is the process? Again, in a sample data set, you will have to select this sample data set, and this time you will have to go to data menu. It is here. So I'll click on data, and in data you will find remove duplicates. You will find a menu, remove duplicates. I'll simply click on remove duplicates, and now I'll get all the variables enlisted here. I'll deselect other variables because I am interested in name only, and I'll go further. I'll click on OK. As I press on OK, MS Excel himself, it deletes the duplicate names. It remove all the duplicates names, fine, and all other 18 unique values remains, fine. So this is the way that we identify duplicates and remove duplicates from the data. Now let me take you all to the MS Excel sheet to demonstrate the same. Now here are the different names and there are some duplicate names. So how to identify them? I'll select this data, complete data, then I'll go to conditional formatting, highlight cells rules, and here duplicate values. This is the process to identify duplicates. To remove duplicates, the process is different. This is the process to identify duplicates only. Fine. So I'll click here on the duplicates value, and as I press on this, a new pop-up window appears. If I press on this arrow, there are only two options, duplicate or unique. Now we are interested in duplicate, and here are different options, yellow fill or green fill and other things. But we are highlight this using light red fill with dark red text. So I'll click on this, then I'll click on OK, and here is the result. Interpretation part we already have discussed, so I'll not spend more time on that. Now I just want to remove those duplicates. Then I'll select this whole data set. Then I'll go to data here. I'll click on data. Then I'll go here to remove duplicates. I'll click on remove duplicates. A new pop-up window appears. Now here are the variables. Now I'll deselect other variables. Otherwise, it will remove all other part also. Now when I have selected name, it will only remove the names and the associated values with those names who are duplicates. Fine. So I'll just click on OK. As I click on OK, here message appears that 4 duplicate values found and they are removed. 18 unique values remain. Fine. So this is the way that we perform or we identify duplicates and we remove duplicates. Now whatever this conditional formatting and all this part we perform here, if we want to clear all these colors, simply select this, go to home, go to conditional formatting, go to clear rule, and just click here on the clear rules from entire sheet or clear rules from selected cells. So I'll press here on this. So all the rules will vanished. Fine. Now let me take you all back to my presentation. Now here in this part of the lecture, we'll try to understand that how can we apply uppercase, lowercase and proper case for the categorical or the qualitative data. Suppose here is a variable gender, and if you look carefully that the responses are typed in a not in a unique pattern. Somewhere we have used first letter as a capital, somewhere we have used first letter a small letter, somewhere all the letters are capital, in somewhere kind of mixture is there. And when such kind of categorical data is there, and if you are performing something, some statistical thing like frequency table or the graphs, then it may lead you to the wrong result or the confusing result. So in a data cleaning, what we actually do is that we apply upper, lower or proper case, whichever suits us, to make it uniform. How we do this? Let me explain. So first just type upper, lower and proper in a separate column, then simply go to upper cell and just type one formula is equal to upper in bracket, you will have to click this cell, first cell only, that is B2, and press enter. You will get all the letters in uppercase, capital letters. Now simply I'll go to this corner and I'll just drag it down to the end. All the responses automatically get converted into uppercase. Same story with the lower, Simply I will go here in this cell and I will type one formula or function that is equal to lower in bracket. I will click here on the first cell and I will just press enter. As I press enter, all the cases, all the this thing that get translated into lower case. Now simply here I will go here on the corner and I will drag it down. All the responses, they get converted into lower case only. And what is proper case? Proper case means the first word is capital and other letters are small letters. Fine. So here again equal to sign, proper, and in bracket I will just click here on mail and then I'll get the responses like this. So this is the way that we apply upper, lower and proper case. Now we'll come to the next part of data cleaning, that is how to remove space between two words. There are chances that when we are typing data, by mistake we have given some extra spaces. When we have given some extra spaces, it also leads to a different result. Now usually we don't apply any statistical thing or the graphical thing on the names, but just for the sake of understanding we are considering this variable here. So here the gap between Soham Kumar is, there is only single space, whereas in Neeta Shah there are at least two or three spaces. So there is a difference between space. How to remove that space, that we are going to deal with here in this part of the lecture. Now simply I will write here space and again I will have to perform some function here. I will click here and I will type equal to trim, T-R-I-M, that is a function that we actually use to remove the space. Then I will click on this cell Soham Kumar and I will press enter. As I press enter, that thing get converted into a single space thing. Now I will go to this corner and I will just drag it down to the end. You can see that all the names now get converted with the inner single space. All the names are having, all the two different words are having only single space. This is the way that we perform the space removal thing. Now let me take you all back to the MS Excel for the demonstration purpose. Fine. So for the upper, lower and proper, I'll just highlight this. We'll be using gender here. Here is upper, say that lower, and here I'll type proper. So how to perform these things? Simply I'll just press equal to sign, then I'll type UPP. As I'm typing the things, that function appears here. So I'll just simply double click here and then I'll click here on this cell which I want to transform into upper cases, and then I'll press enter. As I press enter, I'll go here to the corner of this and I'll just drag it down. Fine. So this is the way we perform upper case. How to perform lower case is equal to LW. As I'm typing this thing, that function appears here. So again, I'll click on that thing, first cell, and I'll enter. So it get converted into the lower case. Now I'll just drag it. Fine. And for the proper, again equal to sign, proper. Here is the proper. So I'll click here. Then I'll click on that particular cell to get it converted. I'll enter. Now here you can find that the first word is capital and others are small, and then I'll drag it. So this is the way that we use upper, lower and proper case. Now for the space removal, what I do for the space removal, now this space removal will perform on names. So let me change the color. Fine. And how we are going to remove the space is equal to sign, T-R-I-M, trim, that function we are going to use. Double click, then you just simply select first cell, bracket close, enter, and then just go and click on this cell, result cell, go to corner and this, then just drag it down. Then all the gaps are removed here in this thing. Fine. So this is the way that we remove. This is the way that we remove the extra spaces which we have used here in our qualitative data. Fine. Now let me take you all back to the presentation and to the last slide of this lecture. So I hope that this lecture has answered all the questions mentioned here. What is data cleaning? I hope that you have understood that. Why should we go with data cleaning? A simple answer is that if we are performing statistical techniques on the raw data, it may lead you to the wrong results or the confusing results. That is why we use data cleaning. So data cleaning is very important part and important step in research. How to do data cleaning? There are different techniques and we have discussed few techniques here in this lecture. Fine. So I hope you've enjoyed this lecture, and here so far this lecture is concerned, we'll stop here. See you soon in the next lecture. Thank you for your kind listening. Thank you.